I knew deep down there's something there. You, as a parent, you know your own child.
They wanted to rule out that it's not the hearing, like that he, yeah, to,
physical.
Yeah, that it wasn't like the physical fact that he couldn't hear causing the developmental delay. Overall, seeking the referrals, getting the assessments done, then getting him the funding, then sourcing out the appropriate people who can do it, and actually stay on board too, because like my son's seen like 5 speeches in the short frame of his life, and he builds these rapport up with people and the professionals. It's so hard for him to do, and then he gets a level of comfortableness, and then they're left there out of the job that someone else is, you know, having to backfill. And it's really tiring, so it's like it's good to have like the extra awareness around it. You need people to bounce off who have done this, who can give you pointers and get you to the like the proper, like the professionals who are good, who's going to work with your child and stuff. It's just there's so many little intricate things that just go into all of this. You know, we obviously have, you know, sister girls in the community, if not like sisters of our own or close, like cousins, that we'll be like, look, like this is what we're going through at the moment. And it's just like, we just like really support one another. We help each other, and like everyone's different. So it's just like, even though they wouldn't have the same things going on with their children as mine, they were just a listening ear, someone for me to vent to on the hard days. Until it's just about that perseverance, it's just about wearing it and just, you know, getting around each other. I think like us as black fellas, like we do that in general. We're so connected with each other that we just like, oh my god, sis, this happened today, like I need someone to talk to. So it's good.
I think as professionals, that's something that we often forget, is that people are opening their heart to you. They're telling you their really personal lives. It's not just ticking a box. It's not just, you know, we're looking at your, observing your child's milestones. It's not about that. It's actually listening and hearing where families are struggling. And I think it really struck me when Thelma said she felt shut down by professionals, because that's not what early intervention services are there for. They're there to provide support, but it seems like a lot of parents seem to find that it's actually a big barrier to even reach out.
Sometimes it's hard to hear a diagnosis and be like, oh, you know, even when son was waiting for his grommets and then figuring out if his developmental delay was caused by him not hearing. And deep down inside, I was like, oh, I hope that's it. And I hope there's no more additional things that we have to look into. Because you as a parent, you just want your kid to thrive in life. You don't want them to have extra barriers. We obviously, as mums and parents and that, like, we get overwhelmed. It's overwhelming, like, caring for them and, you know, but in, you put yourselves in their little shoes and you just, like, their mind must be so busy and they've got all these things they're trying to navigate through. So, you know, it's just really about that reflection and be like, no, hold up, like, this is how it is for him, and we just work around him.
Most Indigenous people, we use a whole different language and different words as it is, and I guess maybe having another, like, our service, Victorian Aboriginal Health Service, you know, they've always got an Aboriginal health worker in there to explain on another level if our parents don't understand what the professionals are saying. And I think, I feel like for us Indigenous mob, we probably need more of that.
Sometimes parents don't know where to start, or they might have them concerns sitting in the back of their head but don't know how to communicate it. So I find even at YAPRA, having them yarns is so important to do with someone you trust, because no one will ever be truly honest of how they're feeling. Like if an MCH said to me, oh, are you worried about any of their, you know, development? A lot of parents tend to say no, where the MCH can see it or the early childhood educators can see it. So I think it's important putting the word out there that it's okay to, you know, yarn about concerns.
be strong, because there's so many people that aren't so strong and don't really know where to go or what to ask. And,
yeah.
you know, people such as yourself, when talking about having yarning circles to bring the community together, because there's so many families out there, because there's too much stigma around it, that don't even look at going for a diagnosis. And then, you know, they'll end up at school without any support whatsoever, and that's where you really come unstuck, and you know, you can be fraught with all sorts of challenges, not just for your own child, but for the school as well, because they don't have that knowledge that you do, and then there's no supports put in place, and that's really challenging in the classroom.
I know, even like me myself, like finding my footing on where to start, how to open up to it, how to explain my concerns, and you know, the shame factor that initially comes with that. Yeah. I think we all have that, because we just want to be the best mum and we want to be on top of everything. And it's hard for us, being such proud people, to be like, look, I'm struggling, like I don't know what to do here. And just breaking down those barriers, because it's so important.
I think there's really an onus on us as professionals to get to know your family and your routine and like what's unique to you, and adjust and adapt activities to what you're doing already.
I think accepting that we're not all perfect. Our children, you know, we're all our children are unique and come with different characteristics and strengths and, you know, everything. But also about yarning and trying to put things in place for community to ensure our children thrive.